people at home.
So you can notice this is plain shapes worksheet, and it has a place where they can create some of their own shapes.
Okay, so go ahead and look over the different shapes that you see. You can stand up and try some of them too. Is there anybody who would be willing to try one of the circle shapes, please? Why don't you take up your flip flops, just so you're safe. Okay, curl up. And did you guys say this is an oval or a circle? It's an oval. And if she were going to make it into a circle, what would she need to do? Ah, look at how she curved her back towards the sky. Nice job. Hey, is there a volunteer who would like to make one of the cube shapes? Now remember, you don't have to do just what's here. You can start now coming up with your own. Emma? Cube or square. Very good. Okay, Emma, this is good. Would you come over here and stand on the light facing this way? Okay, go to second position again. Well, I wouldn't say that normally if you were just not Emma, the dancer, the Tuesday dancer. I would say, Emma, the second grader, could you put your legs apart, please? And then bend down real low. Now, before you lean forward, okay? Well, if you want, you put your hands in your hips, or hands on your knees, because I'm going to ask you to hold this for a while. I don't want you to bend forward. Don't go so low that it hurts, okay? So you guys can see the square that she's making with her legs. It's a little bit. Here we go, hold that, okay? Now, sometimes I have to use visual lines to help me. Because can you see a line in between her fingertips? Can you see, is there a line between her fingertips? No, there's not. So we have to imagine it. So if we have her hold it here, now it's easier to see the line, right? Same thing here, down. Her body is making the shape that we need. And then across here. Now where's the next line? Good. Yes. Right here. Very good. Okay, so we have to use our imagination when we're doing this. Let's give her a hand. Good job. See? And so you use your imagination to create the visual line. It will help you see the shape easier. Is there one more volunteer who'd like to make a shape?
You did. Anybody else?
I'm going to call on you. Come on up. Usually there are a couple people willing. Would you like to make a triangle? Okay, make your own triangle. Ah, yes, so she is a dancer, I can tell right away, because she is making a tangent triangle. And why don't you take off your shoes just so that you can balance while I work on this? And could you put this foot on this line and your toe on that line? Okay, when she makes the shape completely straight on the same line, it's a plain shape. But if she brings it forward, then we're dealing with three dimensions, our length, width, and our depth, which we'll be doing someday, but for second, third, and fourth graders, we don't worry about it. But the kind of shapes on your page are two-dimensional because you're going to be drawing them with stick figures. Thank you, good. Very nice triangle. So go ahead and look. triangle and a triangle, because here's an imaginary or visual line all the way from fingertip to toe. Over here, fingertip to toe. Where's the other line? It actually exists. I don't need to create a pattern. Well, those lines exist too. One, two, three sides. But how do we finish this one? Here's one line. Here's the other line. Where's the third line? Her arms. And you see how that's a real line? Straight across. Good. That's a good one. Oh, and then you have hop, 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 hop.
Yeah.
Very good. Okay. Moving on to rectangles and ovals.
Rectangles.
Yep. Do it. Rectangles.
Thank you.
Now, here's one 90-degree angle. If she takes her knee over her toe, it's a shorter angle, isn't it? So from here, if we go from the middle out to her knee, what number are we going to be on? It's going to be less than 90. 60. Yep, 60. You see that? From the center, we're going to go out towards her knee, and our fingers go right over 60. Great. Okay, now come back to 90. Now, there's another 90-degree angle someplace that she's thinking. Where is it? Yes, her knee and her thigh. So I'm going to scoot over this side so I can see it easier. Why don't you put this elbow on your knee? Great. Okay, scoot back a little. There you go. Okay, so now I'm still going to need to put the bottom line of my giant protractor on her straight line here. But now I can't quite see how to measure this, so I'm going to have to turn it upside down. You're allowed to do that when you work with this tool. Okay? Straight down. Now the problem is, I don't think I can measure this angle having the center over here, so I've got to move it over to here. Now I can look down. And a straight line going straight down. You guys want to walk around and see it? Come on over so you can see it. Just walk right around and be able to see the 90-degree angle. See the numbers? And the interesting thing is when dancers create dances, these specifications are pretty important because it always leans a little bit forward. Now look at this. Different angle. This leg.
Nice.
Very good. So here's Vivian. She's got an obtuse triangle. Sorry, I brought that in here. Kinsey? Okay. Kinsey, why don't you step on the super duper long one with one foot? Okay. And then take the other one in your hand and see how you twist it. Oh, okay. Perfect length for my tall dancer here. All right. Stand up and I'll teach you a dance. You can grab a few minutes, let's give her a hand. So I'm going to give her time.
Thanks for watching.